Hey guys, what's up? It's Hope, and I'm here to bring you my week 75 post-op VSG update. I had vertical sleeve gastrectomy surgery exactly 75 weeks ago this week on July 1st, 2013. This is also my 155th video. 155 videos. Like, that's insane. When I did my very first video, if you would have told me that I would have made 155 videos one day, I would have never believed you. Looking back at like my very first video, you can tell I'm like super nervous and I'm like looking down like here, and I didn't want anyone to see me kind of recording myself even though I was on my lunch break and nobody was even looking. It's just really funny how different I've become and how much has changed and how I've changed, and I don't know. It's just really cool to kind of look back on all those videos. And I'm so grateful that, you know, I did record every single week of this journey. 75 weeks I've recorded a video every single week. And so I'm really grateful for that. It really kind of keeps me in check. It's a way that I can just stay accountable on this crazy wild journey that we're all on. I wanted to make sure and document that. So 75 weeks, 155 videos. This week I'm 185. I started out my highest weight at 330. My day of surgery weight was 306. And last week I came to you weighing 183. This week I'm 185. I'm bouncing between 180 and 185. That is my maintenance range. I am smack dab in the middle of maintenance and just loving it and loving life and trying to figure all of this maintenance stuff out, which has been a really interesting process. But I'm super grateful that I'm finally here in maintenance and living a normal life. So in this video, I kind of wanted to talk a little bit about just an update on the whole baby making thing, and I wanted to update everyone on the boy's birthday because I talked a little bit about that last week, and just how I'm feeling. Obviously, I'm feeling wonderful. I love, love, love this time of year, and I talked about that in my last video. So I am just enjoying it being Christmas time. We've got our tree up and just all the decorations, and I'm just so excited. I love this time of year. So the boys' party was absolutely incredible. It was amazing. We had like 30 people at our house. It was insane, crazy town. Just kids running in and out and just the most amazing kind of chaos. I love, love, love when our house is full of people. And so we had a Plains Fire and Rescue party for them. They turned 3 and 5 within the last couple of weeks. So it's been amazing. I mean, it's just been awesome. It was so much fun, like planning it and then just kind of seeing it all come together was just super awesome. So I wanted to make sure and let y'all know how it went. At the last minute, normally I do decorate their cakes. I love like making cakes and decorating them, and typically I do their cakes every year. I also do my little brother's cake every year. It's just something I've done every single year. I just love baking and decorating cakes. But at the last minute this year, I was like, no, I think I'm gonna buy them. Yeah, Brent wanted a cookie cake and Aiden wanted a regular cake, and I was like, you know, I've done so much for this party already, I'll just go pay to have someone make it. And at the last minute, I changed my mind and was like, you know, I can do this. I'd already pinned like my favorite cake I wanted to do, and I'm so glad I did because it turned out so incredible. If you're friends with me on Facebook, you know that like I posted like a million and one pictures. So I'm super excited about that. Even though none of that is weight loss surgery related, I want to kind of make sure and update y'all on how the party went because a lot of you had asked about it. So thank you so much for asking and caring and wanting to know a little bit about, you know, my life outside of my weight loss surgery journey. So let's talk about the baby making part, because that's like, you know, what we're all crossing our fingers and hoping and praying for, right? That Hope's going to have a little baby before too long. I'm crossing my fingers and hoping and praying that's going to happen for us. I don't think I've ever wanted something so much in my whole entire life. And so it literally consumes our everyday conversations and everyday thoughts and prayers, and I don't know, it's just all worth thinking about at this point in time. So let's talk about kind of an update on that. I am not pregnant. I know last week, last month. I was fingers crossed that I would be pregnant in the month of December, but I'm not pregnant. I know that because I actually started last week, which to a lot of people isn't a big deal, but to me it is. That was literally, you know, I've had, for the last 3 months, I've had back-to-back periods where I've started on my own without medicine. That is huge, y'all. I mean, I went my entire life. I started my period when I was 16 years old, and that was the only time in my whole life, up until I had weight loss surgery, that I had a period without medicine, without it being, you know, medically induced. And so it's huge. It says a whole lot about my body adjusting to the weight loss and my hormone levels. And I mean, for my body to be starting on its own is really a humongous, I don't know if it's an NSV. I don't know if it's just a humongous praise and thank the good Lord up above that my body is finally, you know, it's finally getting to a point where everything's kind of regulating. So me starting this week, even though I'm not pregnant, I am just so grateful for that, because honestly, it really shows and proves that, you know, I'm getting to a point where my body is kind of regulating on its own. So I'm really grateful for that. And so it came, my period kind of came a little early than it was set to. And so it kind of adjusted when my ovulation days are going to be. So my cycles are still not regular. They're still not every so many days I'm having a period. They are still kind of, you know, a little bit farther out. They are, I guess what I'm trying to say is they're not exactly the same every month. And, you know, like I said, I've only got the last 3 or 4 months to really go off of. And so I have an app on my phone where I'm kind of tracking and documenting my cycle lengths and days, and when my fertility, my ovulation days are. So, this month I'm actually going to be tracking it with my temperature, and I haven't done that before, but I'm really excited to do that because I want to kind of see how it adds up to, sorry, there's person's brake lights are kind of in my face, so it's kind of radiating. But I do want to kind of see how my temperatures match the app on my phone and how it kind of tells me, you know, my app on my phone tells me when my ovulation days are going to be. And so I want to kind of double check that, I guess, and back that up with checking my temperatures every day. So I am going to be doing that this month. And so that will be kind of another insight to my ovulation days. Since my cycles still are super regular and they're not coming at the exact same day every month, but at least I'm getting them every month, y'all. And that is just a huge thing. It's just proof that my body is trying to regulate and do what it's supposed to do. And so that's another huge thing for me, because I feel like I'm normal, and I mean, I've never been normal. So I've never been normal, but I mean, my body has never been normal, and my weight has never been at a weight where I can actually feel comfortable maintaining it. So, it really is a lot going on right now in my body and in my life. And, I don't know. And so I really kind of feel like, going back to the whole trying to get pregnant, you know, super early, not waiting. I mean, honestly, we waited until I was about 6 or 7 months post-op. I'd already lost like 100 pounds. And that's when we really started kind of trying, because I had a feeling that it was going to take us a little while. Even at that point, my periods hadn't come back yet. I was still taking my medicine to have my periods induced every month. And so now I really feel like we are in the throes of it. We are, you know, tracking my ovulation, my normal period that I don't have to take a pill to have. And so that's a huge deal. And so I kind of feel like we really are, you know, I'm over a year post-op. I'm a year and a half post-op. My periods are coming on their own. I'm in maintenance. So if I get pregnant right now, it really would be the absolute perfect time. But of course, I am just leaving that up to God. We are praying and praying and praying that now is our time. I do want to share something really amazing that happened to me this last weekend. I went to a baby shower and I was really super nervous about it. I had been invited to another baby shower that I just couldn't go to. I just was really emotional about it. And I know there are people out there who understand. Sarah Harrison had actually talked about this in some of her videos where, you know, before she had surgery, when her and her husband were trying to get pregnant, and it was really hard for her to go to baby showers. And I can totally relate to that. a couple of Andy's cousins had gotten pregnant within the last year or so, and one is actually getting ready to have her baby, and one isn't due until the end of January. And I don't know, like, I've just tried my hardest, my very best, to not be jealous. And but it's hard. It's hard when it's just kind of like one of those things where they're not even trying and they get pregnant. And yes, you know, it's amazing and I'm so happy for them, but I can't help but to wish, oh, you know, what about us? You know, we're really trying. God, please make this dream come true. But we went to his little cousin's baby shower. I think she's like 20 years old. And so we went to her baby shower last week, and he didn't go, obviously. But after the baby shower was over, his aunt came up to me, and this is actually his second cousin. So it's his cousin's daughter, if you're following me. And so his aunt is actually the girl who's pregnant. That's her grandmother. So it's Andy's second cousin. I know that's too much explaining and it's getting confusing, but Andy's aunt came up to me after the shower. It was hosted at her house, and she said, hey, I wanted to let you know we're going to pray over the women who want to get pregnant. And so we're just going to pray that, you know, God sees for this to happen and that it's his plan for it to happen right now for all of you. And I was like, oh my gosh, that would be really amazing. I've never had someone, you know, pray over me before, specifically related to, you know, a baby. That would be amazing. And so I was completely open to it. And so after the baby shower was over, of course, all of the other women who, you know, were trying to get pregnant had left. So it was just me there. And I was like, oh geez, you know, it's just gonna be me. And I hoped it wouldn't be awkward. And I didn't want to take away from his cousin's baby shower. Like, it was her special day. And I was worried about, you know, it taking over that. But it was so beautiful. Like, they literally put their hands on me and they were praying, and I literally was a crying mess. There was just so much faith and so much hope in that one moment, and so many, like, amazing women that I respect and admire were coming together and just praying for me and Andy, and that this would happen. And it was just such an amazing thing that happened. So I wanted to kind of document that. No, it's not weight loss surgery related. And who knows, maybe that beautiful little prayer circle is, you know, what is going to lead us to a baby. You know, I have faith and I believe in God, and I believe is in his plan for our lives. And I am just like, we're just praying and praying, praying that he sees fit to, you know, bless us with a baby. So, I don't know. I wanted to share that because it was really an amazing experience to have someone, you know, all of them just kind of come together in agreement that they believe that this is going to happen for us. And so just praying and having faith that it's going to happen. And it was just really amazing. I just wanted to make sure and share that. And it's a part of my journey. This whole fertility, trying to get pregnant thing is a part of my weight loss surgery journey. You know, my journey has been one of ups and downs and, you know, just crazy stuff happening. And my whole life has been like that. And I've shared a little bit about that with all of you. And so, I don't know. If y'all will please continue praying for me and Andy, I would definitely appreciate it. You know, we are doing everything we need to do. So, we're just crossing our fingers that it happens for us. So, still in maintenance, 185. 100 and almost 150 pounds lost since my highest weight. It's getting dark, and so y'all won't be able to see me before too long. Another one of those benefits of, you know, fall backwards. But I wanted to make sure and document all of that. As far as how I'm feeling incredible. This shirt I'm wearing is actually my sister's, which is a huge NSV, and I still have a hard time dealing with that. But whenever she was over for Thanksgiving, she accidentally left it at my house. And I found it and washed it and totally wore it to work today. I've never been able to do that before. I've never been able to wear my sister's clothes. And so it's really cool that we were able to do that. I actually sent her a picture of me wearing it and was like, hey, do you know whose super cute shirt this is? And she was like, oh, I've been looking everywhere for that. And I was like, yeah, I'm totally wearing it. She was like, oh my gosh. But it's just really cool for us because we have never been able to wear each other's clothes. So it's just really neat. Okay, guys, I will let y'all go for week 75. I've rambled on long enough. It's been forever since I did like a 14-minute video. So hopefully y'all enjoy it and I didn't ramble on too much. Thank you all so much for watching and following my journey, and praying for me and lifting me up and thinking of me. And I appreciate every single one of you who has followed me for 155 videos. That's insane crazy. And so I will let you guys go for now. I'm hoping and praying you all have an amazing week. And I will see you guys next week for week 76. Bye!